Heart failure is a condition that can initially be managed with medications. But if it progresses to an advanced stage, medications and other treatments may not be as effective. When your heart reaches this stage, a ventricular assist device, which we call a VAD, may be the best option to support the pumping function of your heart. A VAD will not cure heart failure, but it can help relieve your physical symptoms like shortness of breath and fatigue. The decision to get a VAD is not an easy one. While the VAD may be able to extend your life, it requires a complex open heart surgery, commitment to complex aftercare, and your adjustment to a new normal. Once it is implanted, the VAD becomes a part of you, and you will always have it. A VAD is a mechanical pump that is surgically attached to your heart and helps pump blood throughout your body. The pump is attached to your heart and connected with a drive line that exits the body at the abdomen. Outside the body, the drive line is connected to a controller and a power source, a battery pack or a wall outlet. The battery pack lasts 6 to 12 hours and weighs 7 pounds, about the weight of a gallon of milk. When you're stationary or sleeping, the VAD should be connected to a wall outlet. The VAD must always be connected to a power source, so when you leave your home, you must take your backup controller and batteries. Life with a VAD requires serious commitment to care from both the patient and their caregiver or caregiving team. You will require a caregiver's care round the clock for the first 3 months after hospital discharge. Thereafter, you will rely on your caregiver to help you with medication, frequent clinic visits and blood draws, equipment maintenance, responding to equipment alarms, and bandage changing. Driveline site care is exceedingly important to prevent infections and complications. Your caregiver must clean the site, check for signs of infection, and change bandages at least once a week. We recommend that you do not shower because we believe it increases your risk of infection at the driveline site. We recognize, though, that many patients with VADs do choose to shower. If you make the decision to shower, please let us know prior. You'll need to obtain the manufacturer's equipment to reduce the risk of showering. We can provide you with the equipment and instructions on how to use the equipment. Being constantly connected to wall power or a battery pack is also a huge adjustment for patients. The batteries weigh about as much as a gallon of milk. A patient can wear them on a belt or in a vest and must have an additional battery pack on hand at all times.
Before the VAD, back in the fall, my health was going downhill rapidly and I couldn't walk up steps. I couldn't sleep. I'd go 3 days straight and not be able to sleep a wink. I really couldn't do everyday chores. I basically laid on the couch and was unable to do really any functions whatsoever. Now I can do anything that I used to do, a year ago. Now that I had the VAD installed, it just totally brought my life back to me. So we really have a staging area in our bedroom for getting up in the morning. I mean, we have the battery charger, and then there's a tablet that I report every morning to Hershey Medical Center, all of my stats from my controller. Batteries give me a lot of flexibility. I can do whatever I want. I only use the AC where I plug in at night when I sleep. You know, the wire only gives you 20 feet or whatever it is of walking space. So the batteries really give you a lot of flexibility to do what you need to do. For me, the vest gives me flexibility because I can free up both of my arms. When I do go to the grocery store or whatever I'm going to do, I already have the bag with my backup supplies in it, and I didn't want to have two bags to carry, so I opted for the vest. To adjust to the new normal, it took me several months. But now it's second nature to me. After you get dressed, you buckle your belt and then you put your vest on and you put your equipment on and off you go for the rest of the day.
No two VAD patients are the same. But the most successful patients are those who engage in planning for their recovery with the VAD team, their caregivers, and their families. The Heart and Vascular Institute will help you to develop a comprehensive plan for recovery and aftercare. you and your family should consult the Decision Tool booklet that includes questions you'll want to consider. We encourage you to write down your questions and concerns and discuss them with members of the care team while you're in the hospital, at appointments, or via phone calls. We're here to assist you as you make this decision. If you make the decision to move forward with VAD implementation, you will undergo a series of tests to ensure that a VAD is the right treatment choice for you. Once approved, you and your family will meet with many members of the Penn State Support Network to plan for your VAD surgery. You'll meet with a cardiothoracic surgeon to discuss which VAD pump is right for you, the surgery, and postoperative care. Under the direction of a surgeon are VAD coordinators, registered nurses who will teach you and your caregiver about your VAD before and after surgery. They'll also assist with post-surgical care and clinical visits. VAD coordinators will evaluate your support system and your ability to cope with the treatment plan. They will collaborate with a VAD nurse practitioner to oversee other aspects of your care, including follow-up with you and your family with results of tests and procedures. A social worker will support you and your caregiver with resources, counseling, and assistance with insurance. They will evaluate your support system and your ability to cope with the treatment plan. A financial counselor will help you plan for the financial aspects of your treatment plan, from evaluation through postoperative care. They'll work with your insurance company and identify out-of-pocket expenses. Chaplains offer you and your family spiritual care, emotional support, and coping and healing resources. You'll meet with the palliative care team to discuss your care goals before you're approved for a VAD. The team is also available after the VAD has been implanted. The VAD team is here to support you from this moment forward. You can contact us anytime you have questions or need support.
Depending on the complexity of the operation, it can take anything between 4 and 6 hours, and that includes the time before starting with the surgery with the anesthesiologists. The operation is done under general anesthesia, and typically it involves a midline incision in the chest and dividing the breastbone, the sternum. So once we have access to the heart and are able to place the pump in the appropriate position, we connect the patient to a device called the heart-lung machine, which essentially does the work of the heart and the lungs and allows us to open the heart and implant the pump into the heart. And once the pump is implanted and assembled, the cable that delivers electricity to the pump, called the drive line, is tunneled and passed through the side of the abdominal wall and connected to the power supply. So once the pump is connected and powered up, we gradually wean the patient from the heart-lung machine as the pump takes over the function of the heart. Anesthesia isn't reversed at the end of these operations, because the first few hours after surgery, patients are in critical condition and we have to keep a close eye on them, and we will not wake patients up until we're satisfied that everything is functioning well and there is no bleeding or any other reason to concern us.
I would like to explain to you what you can expect postoperatively after you have your left ventricular assist device implanted. You will come into the ICU directly from the operating room. Besides having the new controller for your VAD at your bedside, you will have a breathing tube down your throat until you're awake and alert enough to have it removed. You will also have an IV in your neck, as well as IVs in your arms. You will have drains in your chest, known as chest tubes. We will try to minimize your pain as much as possible. And within the next couple days, we will be getting you out of bed with the assistance of physical therapy, as well as occupational therapy. The care team at your bedside will be going over all of the new medications that you will be on postoperatively. And the MCS team will be spending several hours with you, educating you on your new LVAD and what you can expect when you go home. If you are considering this therapy as an option, please know that myself and the VAD team are here to ensure the smoothest transition to a new normal. Oftentimes this is a bumpy road and isn't easy for everyone, but we are here to help you through that.
The complications after an LVAD surgery can be divided into two phases. There are immediate complications which are related to the operation itself, and then there are long-term complications which are related to living with a left ventricular assist device. The immediate complications are things like bleeding, and sometimes the bleeding requires a return visit to the operating room to deal with the potential causes of that. Infection, which can occur early post-operative period as well as a late complication. And this can occur in the any of the surgical incisions or at the site of the driveline exiting the body. Failure of the right ventricle is sometimes seen after an LVAD operation. Long term, when patients have recovered from the operation, infection is a risk. Again, long term, there is a balance between the blood being too thin, causing bleeding, and that can occur within the gastrointestinal tract, or the blood being too thick and forming clots within the pump or within the heart, which again can cause complications such as stroke. With the aid of a stethoscope, you can hear a hum generated by these pumps. They are very quiet. Depending on the design of the pump and where it's located, some of them are within the chest cavity and some of them are actually in the abdominal wall. They can be aware of fullness in their abdominal wall, abdominal cavity. The pumps that are within the chest, typically individuals are not conscious of them. The driveline clearly is a part of life. I have not come across many patients who are uncomfortable necessarily by the pump itself. And I think if it weren't for the driveline, most patients would probably not be aware of what's in on the inside. As imperfect as this treatment, this therapy may be, it has been a life-changing and life-saving experience for thousands of patients that would not be alive today if it wasn't for these devices.
No two patients recover the same way. You may be discharged into the care of your personal in-home caregiver, into the care of visiting nurses, or into a rehabilitation facility. Regardless of your discharge details, you will require round-the-clock care for at least the first 3 months after hospital discharge. You'll be prescribed blood thinner medications known as anticoagulants that prevent clots from forming in the VAD pump. These anticoagulants will require twice weekly blood draws to monitor your level of anticoagulation. You and your caregiver will also attend a series of follow-up appointments, including a 7-day post-operative visit and monthly clinic appointments with a VAD nurse and cardiologist. On an ongoing, daily basis, you must record the numbers from your pump, your blood pressure, weight, and temperature. You will rely on your caregiver to help you with medication, equipment maintenance, responding to equipment alarms, driveline site cleaning and bandaging, and some personal care. You may also experience complications with the VAD that may require rehospitalization or repeat surgeries. Complications may include device malfunction, driveline site infection, gastrointestinal bleeding, renal failure, and stroke.
When I first got out of the hospital, I thought, oh man, I hope this isn't the rest of my life, because I didn't have energy, I didn't feel that well and everything else, but I don't know, after what, 4 or 5 weeks?
About a month and a half, things started kicking
in, and I'm back to doing my flea markets and cutting firewood and all that good stuff. So, you know, it didn't take that long, really, in the whole scope of things, to get back to somewhat of a normal. You know, the LVAD, it did change me, but you know, not drastically. I can still do a lot of the stuff that I used to do, but maybe not as fast. You know, I got to take my time, and also you got to think things out a little bit, because you do have batteries and you do have a controller, so you got to be careful of the cables, and you know, so sometimes you just got to stop and think a minute. Well, you know, what could happen if I do this? You know, first they give you these things you wear on your sides, and they didn't work, so I ended up buying pants with deep pockets, and I stick my batteries in my pockets, and I have a little pouch here for my other thing. So, but it took a couple weeks to figure out how I wanted to wear them. Caregivers are just, for me, they were so important. And I've probably have two of the best.
It was hard going through it before, but once he had it, the transition was a little easier than I thought, just to get back to everything. And now I don't even think about it much. It didn't take long for everything to become normal again, minus going to the beach, which he didn't really like the hot sand anyway. It was hard because it was a time when I was going to school and kind of moving out naturally on my own. So before, I wasn't spending as much time, but now I spend the nights a lot more, come and cook dinner, and spend a lot more quality time, I guess, to kind of realize you need that quality time after something like that, too.
It was just going through motions, I feel, when I look back. I felt like I just did what I knew I had to do. The one thing that I learned shortly before he was discharged, one of the nurses said, he's actually doing very well. Well, that part really startled me because he looked so awful. Accept offers of help. Ask for help. Don't be afraid, because it takes a while to really get your strength and for me to reach my new normal, it took several weeks.
For me, being his daughter, it was a little different transitioning into a caregiver, because I always relied on him for everything. Support that I needed was always coming from him. So it was a little different to transition into me giving the support to him and him relying on me. So with that being said, I think our relationship has actually gotten closer and better, because we have a whole new dynamic to it and a whole new appreciation for each other too. So we have appreciation for life, appreciation for each other, and things are going great with it, so.
I don't know, I wasn't really in a frame of mind to think about what you're gonna do to me. All I cared about is, if you could do something to keep me alive, you just go ahead and do it, and I don't wanna know what you're gonna do, but if something's gonna keep me alive for another week, another year, just go ahead and do it. And what else could I say? You know, if they give you the choice of maybe not making it or getting an LVAD, yeah, take it. Every day that I've lived after that has been a gift. So, you know, it's I don't know what else to say.
His girlfriend and I basically just talked about how we wanted him in our life in any way possible that could happen. That's what would have to happen. So with the LVAD, I don't know if there is ever a chance when you really fully get to decide, because it's not like you get to decide to have heart issues or anything like that. It's just you decide to live, and that's what we all decided.
The VAD team here at the Hershey Medical Center are here to support you while you make a consideration for a ventricular assist device. We know that it requires a lot of commitment from you, your family, and your caregivers. We encourage you to take time and reflect, speak with your VAD coordinators, and your family.
If you decide that a VAD is the right decision for you and your family, we'll move forward with a VAD evaluation, a series of tests and visits from the VAD multidisciplinary team.
Whatever decision you and your family make, understand that myself and the rest of the team are here to help you along the way.